Hi guys, welcome back to Explanator. This session is on series RC circuit, the current equation, power equation and power plot is what we are going to look at in today's video. To build a series RC circuit, we need a resistor, a capacitor and AC supply. Putting them in series means that the same current flows through the resistor and the capacitor. The alternating voltage applied is given by the equation V equals Vm sine of omega t. Let the current flowing in the closed circuit be of magnitude I. This current, when it flows through the resistor, it drops a voltage Vr and it drops a voltage Vc when it flows through the capacitor. We have to find an equation for this current flowing in the circuit. To derive the relation, use the phasor diagram. The phasor has three voltages represented as three sides of the right-handed triangle with the value for V given as V square equal to Vr square plus minus Vc the whole square. The detailed steps involved in the drawing of the diagram have already been explained in the earlier videos. Before writing the equation for current, take a quick recap of how phasor diagram and the equation for current in a pure resistive and pure capacitive circuit are represented. You can see that in a pure resistor, V and I are in phase, while in a purely capacitive circuit, they are 90 degrees apart. Now, when you combine both elements together in the circuit, the current and the voltage will have a phase difference somewhere between 0 and 90 degrees. We call that angle as phi. The value will be calculated in the coming stages. With this assumption, we write the equation for current as Im sine of omega t plus phi. To find the magnitude of the current Im, consider the right-handed triangle and with the Pythagoras theorem, you get the relation V square equal to Vr square plus minus Vc the whole square. Substitute Vr as Ir and Vc as Ixc. Simplify to get an equation for current I. I can be written as V divided by square root of R square plus Xc square. Substitute V as Vm sine of omega t and you see that when sine reaches the maximum value, the voltage and hence the current will also reach their maximum values. So the value for maximum current, that is Im, is given as Vm divided by square root of R square plus Xc square, where the term square root of R square plus Xc square is called as impedance of the circuit denoted by letter Z. Coming to computing the value of the phase angle phi, if you consider the triangle again and write an expression for tan phi, it will be equal to minus Vc by Vr. Substitute Vr as Ir and Vc as Ixc. Cancel the common term I and the relation will simplify to minus Xc upon R. So phi is given as tan inverse of minus Xc upon R. The negative angle means voltage lags current. You can also say that current leads the voltage. It means one and the same. The final value for current in a series RC circuit can now be written as Vm divided by root of R square plus Xc square multiplied by sine of omega t plus tan inverse of minus Xc upon R. Now that we have the equations for voltage and current, we can draw their waveforms. Draw the voltage waveform first. Before drawing the current in the series RC, for comparison, draw the current waveforms of resistor and capacitor as well. In case of a pure resistor, current is in phase, so wave starts from zero. And in case of a capacitor, it leads by 90 degrees. Hence, it starts 90 degrees before the voltage wave. For RC, the phase angle phi is some value between 0 and 90 determined by the values of x, c and r. So the final waveform will look like that shown here. With the voltage and current equations and their plots, it is possible to derive the power equation as well as plot the graph for power. For instantaneous power P, which is equal to V into I, substitute the values and simplify using trigonometric identities. You will get P equal to Vm Im by 2 into cos phi minus cos of 2 omega t plus phi. The terms may be separated and written as Vm Im by 2 cos phi minus Vm Im by 2 cos of 2 omega t plus phi. Next, to find the average power, integrate the equation over the working cycle, that is from 0 to 2 pi, and divide it by the total time interval. The integration is carried out with respect to omega t. The first part of the equation has no omega t, so all terms are constant. Integration of that part will give Vm Im by 2 into cos phi, while the second term has cos of omega t, and we know that average value of cos is 0 from 0 to 2 pi. So the second part will return a value 0. The 2 in the denominator may be written as root 2 into root 2. Hence, the equation can be simplified to Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2, which can further be written as Vrms into Irms into cos phi. To plot the average power, draw the voltage waveform followed by the current waveforms as done earlier. If you multiply both, you will see that the resultant curve has a pattern as shown. But unlike in case of a pure capacitor, the negative halves are not large enough to cancel out the positive halves. So there will be some definite power loss, but it depends on the values of R and C in the series circuit. Thank you for watching. Do let me know if you have any suggestions by dropping in your comments. Like, share and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.